At St. Madeleine Sophie Center, we educate and empower individuals with developmental disabilities. How do we do this? We do this through nationally recognized programs that educate through liberal arts, practical skills, employment, and the culture of care for the dignity of life.
Jenna, do you remember how and when St. Madeleine Sophie's Center began?
Yes, it really began with a group of parents who had their children in the school adjoining the property here in about 1962, 1963. These children of theirs weren't able to attend the public schools, so they asked Sister Mardell for some instruction.
These young people, were they developmentally disabled?
Yes, they were, and there was no possibility at that time for them to attend the public schools.
I have a long history here at St. Madeleine Sophie Center. In 1991, I was pregnant with our son, James, who has Down syndrome. I'm also alumna of the Sacred Heart, and Sister Maxine Kramer was the director of St. Madeleine Sophie Center in 1991, and at that time, wanted me to know that our son, James, will have a future at St. Madeleine Sophie Center. 22 years later, we live in Carlsbad, and now James has just completed his third week at St. Madeleine Sophie Center, and we're driving him 3 days a week to come to this very, very special program, which is really the best in all of San Diego County. And if you ask James, he gives it a double thumbs up.
This beautiful organic garden that you see before you all began in the mid-1990s through a grant that we received from the San Diego County Credit Union. From those simple beginnings, we were able to bring on staff with the expertise and training to be able to work with our students to be able to plant, nurture, and propagate all that you see around you. Our students were able to take that experience and apply it to their own personal lives to help them to become more productive, as well as to be able to see the fruits of their own labors.
Before I came here, I had nothing to do. I was bored stiff. I mean, I did nothing but clean up the house, and that was basically about it. So I had to have someplace to go because I was going nuts. So I came here, and they gave me something to do.
I'm the vice president of the Staff Accuracy Board, and we are here to help the students and the community.
I get out more, I have more things to do, that sort of thing.
We also do this fundraisers, and we also do the dances.
I feel more useful because I get to do things here at St. Madeleine's.
A lot of other people love it, and a lot of people love St. Mads because it's fun.
You know, it's family here at St. Madeleine Sophie Center for over 400 students. Everyone lives a beautiful life with quality and dignity and a sense of self-esteem. I know this personally because my sister is a student here. She's developmentally disabled, and we moved her all the way from New York to be a part of St. Madeleine Sophie Center. Since she's been here 13 years ago, her life is filled with friendship and love, high self-esteem, nurturing, growing, learning for life, and above all, a sense of dignity. For me, it's more than being board president at St. Madeleine's. For my sister and me, it's family.
How many students began, and did they have a building, or did they create a school, or what?
Actually, it was very small at that time, 12 students, and they built up to 20 students, and they built the Parkman building here on campus. The building consisted of two small classrooms, two rooms, and an office, and a large gathering room. So as they grew, it became difficult, and the next building that was added was the Ferrantelli building, given by the Ferrantelli family.
And that's the one that we still have today?
Exactly. Both of those buildings are still used today, the Parkman and the Ferrantelli building.
And this is Sophie's Art Gallery, where we've been here since December 1999 in downtown El Cajon. Typically, on any given day, we have up to 40 students come here from our main center to do their artwork and learn new skills and new techniques. It gives them an opportunity to be creative with our staff and produce tremendous work, which they're able to market as well. This is the public gallery. The public come in, they love what they see, they purchase it, and the profits are shared between all the artists and the center.
St. Madeleine Sophie Center transports Ryan, my son, 5 times a week, which is a great relief for me and a great opportunity for him. 3 times a week, he comes to Sophie's gallery, which they also transport him to. He gets the opportunity to make these beautiful paintings, jewelry, and other artwork. Ryan not only creates his artwork here, he gets to display it and sell it and gets to keep a portion of the money. And the other portion of the money goes to St. Madeleine Sophie Center to help keep this program going. I'm so proud of him. I'm so happy for him that he has this opportunity at St. Madeleine Sophie Center, as well as the gallery here. I never dreamed that he would have had these opportunities. And I just love this place, and I love him being here.
In 1965, it was the centenary of our foundress, St. Madeleine Sophie, and that's very important because of the name of the center today. They wanted to do something to honor her, and so they established the school, and it was known as the Center for Disabled Children at that time.
This beautiful facility has grown from 20 students to 400 in the space of almost 50 years. That is really amazing. And how is it that it has developed so rapidly and so beautifully?
Well, I would say the donors have been very generous over the years. And in the very beginning, it was the auxiliary of St. Madeleine Sophie Center who contributed very significantly. And in recent years, the Kramer Endowment Foundation has been most supportive. But all of those donors have been very instrumental in continuing this legacy and tradition of St. Madeleine Sophie Center.
So we have them to thank for the beautiful pool and for the gardens and for the tremendous growth of the art programs and all the other programs that we have, even the computer lab and everything else. We have them to thank for all of this.
Absolutely.
And we also have the directors who have been, we have been so fortunate and so gifted in the directors that have led St. Madeleine Sophie's and guided it and directed it in these directions.
Indeed, that leadership and the vision that they have had over these years has changed it from a very small entity into one that is very significant in our community.
This is my card that I'm doing for the fashion show. I'm very proud of it. I worked very hard doing this card. This is the card of Anne Margaret. Kind of looks like Anne Margaret, right? I do artwork here at Sophie's Gallery at St. Madeleine's. And I really love this card. So I'm an artist at Sophie's Gallery. How about that?
We believe people with developmental disabilities keep learning. We do that through nurturing, creating opportunities, and jobs for our students in the community. We do that here every day.